After he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? He said, it is finished. Means what? When he was drinking the cup, it looked like God has forsaken. But God did not forsake. That's why he could say, it is finished. Yeah. How many understood?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
How many understood?
Yeah.
After that, he said, it is finished. In the resurrection, in the ascension, and in the enthronement, Jesus had a testimony. In resurrection, his testimony. You know how the apostles preached the gospel. But what is written in the book of Acts? The apostles said, you crucified Christ, God raised him up. You crucified Christ, God raised him up. Tell your neighbor, God will never crucify you. He is the one who experienced crucifixion to raise you up. What does Ephesians say? Ephesians says, that you might know what is the exceeding greatness of his power, which he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead, far above all principality, all power, all dominion, all authority. And you he has raised together with Christ and seated you in heavenly places. So where are you prophesying from? Where are you prophesying from? It's different to prophesy as a resurrected being. It's different to prophesy as an ascended being. Lazarus resurrected, but he did not ascend. He was still under the power of principalities and powers. That's why once again he died. Jesus resurrected, but this time he was not under any principality or power. God ascended him, raised him up far above every principality, every power, every dominion, every authority, and put him at his own right hand. Put him at the same throne where God said, oh God, my God, your throne is forever. And God said, you are my son. Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool. Why is the testimony of Jesus important to us? Because when we see his testimony, we can know he is faithful to give us our testimony. When we see his testimony, we know, yes, it might look like men are crucifying me. It might look like sickness is crucifying me. It might look like God has forsaken me. But the truth is, God in me can only swallow this up. God in me will never leave me nor forsake me.